And joining us now is Barb Langridge, from a bookandahug.com with some of her favorite books for Black History Month. Yep. Good morning. Thanks for being here, Barb.
Thank you so much. Barry, I'm going to kick us off here with a book that I call a kapow book.
A kapow book.
Yes. A Nation's Hope. This is by Matt De La Pena, and it is illustrated by the master, Kadir Nelson. Okay. Yankee Stadium, 1938, summer night. The most important boxing match to ever happen is about to happen. Mm-hmm. You're going to have a guy who is the son of a black sharecropper going up against Hitler's master race. Mm-hmm. Okay? Where did this guy come from? Joe Louis did not talk until he was 6 years old, and when he did talk, he stammered, and everybody made fun of him. You know, so you would look at this kid and you'd think, oh, not going to amount to much.
Right.
But he would look at his hands, and they were huge, and he would think, I have a future in these hands. And he did. As the Nazis are filling the concentration camps, Joe Louis is going to go up against that German candidate, and the 70,000 people in that stadium are like, please, we need a hero, we need somebody to really do this, and he delivers a knockout punch. Mm-hmm. If you know this story, you don't know it like this guy wrote this story. It is absolutely beautiful, and the illustrations are fantastic. So that's A Nation's Hope.
Okay.
I would say ages, you could do it with six and up. You would love it.
Well, I'm going to go back and just to see it.
Absolutely. Right. Okay, now speaking of hands, the next one is These Hands. It's written by Margaret H. Mason. This is a grandfather talking to his grandson, and he's looking at his hands, and he's saying, you know, these hands can tie a triple bowline knot in 3 seconds. These hands used to be able to throw a curveball. These hands could do a waterfall shuffle. These hands could not touch the dough in the Wonder Bread factory. Whoa. Well, now the grandson looks at his hands. He can probably throw a curveball someday. He can definitely work in the Wonder Bread factory. He can do anything he wants with his hands.
Okay.
So what the grandfather has given to the grandson is amazing. And again, you could do six and up.
And it's information as to you can be what you want to be.
It's inspiring.
Right.
Okay. Now this is called Underground. It's by Shane W. Evans. When we say Underground Railroad to kids, I think they all envision something like the Metro or Subway that goes under the ground all the way up to Canada or something. You know, I mean, it's natural. This book only has 49 words. I counted them.
The book only has 49
yes.
words?
Yes. And they packed a punch. You totally get the experience of getting on the Underground Railroad. The courage.
The one page, the escape.
The escape, yes. We are quiet. I mean, it's so subtle, the fear. Look at that. Do you get fear from that? Hmm. He's getting fear from that. Okay. This is an incredibly powerful book that really explains the Underground Railroad because it conveys what was it like to be that person to take that risk.
Okay. And
7 Miles to Freedom.
Mm-hmm.
Go to Charleston, South Carolina. It's right at the beginning of the Civil War. And this guy has a huge decision to make. He is standing on board a steamer, a ship in the harbor, and he is thinking, should I or shouldn't I? Should I risk my life, the lives of my family, or not? He's born a slave. How did he get here? He's standing on this ship. Every white sailor has gotten off that ship for the night and gone on to the land. He's got 4 cannon that are destined for a Confederate fort. He knows all the secret steamboat whistle sounds. He could move that ship through that harbor past all those forts, give them the little signal, get by, and escape with his family. But if they catch him, everybody's doomed.
Right.
Should he do it? Would you? Ooh, isn't that cool?
And so now we see what the story is. Okay, now just a few more seconds.
Okay,
tell us about
Birmingham, 1963. You guys, don't miss this. This is 100 years later, but it's absolutely fantastic. It's her 10th birthday. She's going to put on her patent leather shoes. She's going to have a sip of coffee. She's going to get in the car and go to church and Sunday school with her family. She's got clammy hands because she's thinking, I get to sing my solo, This Little Light of Mine.
Mm-hmm.
And then a bomb explodes. Cynthia, Denise, Addie Mae, and I'm forgetting one name, and we don't want to forget her.
Okay.
Carol. Those four little girls are gone. This is a poetic kapow book that any 9-10-year-old can understand. And the last one is Eliza's Freedom.
We're really out of time, but can you just tell us real quick Eliza's Freedom?
Jerdy Nolan, this is a diary. She's on the eastern shore of Maryland. You might recognize it. She's 11 years old. Her mother's been sold. Can she find a miracle?
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Thanks, Barb. We appreciate you
coming in.
My pleasure. All right. And for more information, you can check out Barb's website at bookandahug.com.